नेक्स्ट स्पीकर इज डॉक्टर आशुतोष शुक्ला।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
या कंटिन्यू प्लीज।
दिस इज डॉक्टर आशुतोष शुक्ला फ्रॉम लीलावती हॉस्पिटल मुंबई। अब टॉपिक ऑफ माय पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन इज प्रिंसिपल्स इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ इंट्रामेडुलरी ट्यूमर। ए 46 ईयर ओल्ड मेल वाज एडमिटेड लीलावती हॉस्पिटल विद द कंप्लेंट ऑफ मॉडरेट अपर बैक पेन सिंस 2 मंथ्स, टिंगलिंग एंड नमनेस इन बायलेटरल लोअर लिम्स, इम्पेयर टेम्परेचर सेंसेशंस इन बायलेटरल लोअर लिम्स एंड डिफिकल्टी इन वॉकिंग, बट बाउल एंड बेडल वॉज इंटैक्ट। ऑन एग्जामिनेशन टोन वॉज इंक्रीज इन बायलेटरल लोअर लिम्स, बायलेटरल नी जर्क एंकल जर्क वर एग्जैगरेटेड, बायलेटरल प्लांटर वॉज एक्सटेंसर एंड द परिनल सेंसेशन वॉज इंटैक्ट, टेम्परेचर सेंसेशन वॉज इम्पेयर बिलो D4 लेवल बायलेटरली। दिस इज प्री ऑप MRI, फर्स्ट MRI। हियर वी कैन सी देयर इज अप्रोक्सिमेट आइसो इंटेंस ट्यूमर फ्रॉम D2 टू D5 विद सेरिंग विद मिनिमल हेट्रोजेनस कॉन्ट्रास्ट एनहांसमेंट सीन इन बोथ एक्सियल एंड द एक्सियल व्यू। ऑपरेशन ऑफ द प्लान इन प्रोन पोजिशन। हियर आफ्टर रिसेक्शन ऑफ सॉफ्ट टिश्यू ड्यूरल इंसिजन वॉज टेकन। नाउ वी कैन सी द अर्कनाइट, दिस इज अर्कनाइट इंसिजन एंड दिस इज द एंटर ऑफ वीडियो। नाउ प्लेइंग हियर वी आफ्टर मायलोटॉमी वी कैन सी हियर वी कैन सी दिस वन, दिस इज अ ग्रेस वाइट सॉफ्ट सकेबल ट्यूमर विथ गुड प्लेन। सी वी आर सकिंग द ट्यूमर। एंड द एंटायर प्रोसीजर एंटायर ऑपरेशन वॉज मॉनिटर एंड गाइडेड बाई द इंटर ऑपरेटिव न्यूरो मॉनिटरिंग, होल थिंग वॉज रिकॉर्डेड एंड द मॉनिटर एंड इंटर ऑपरेटिव न्यूरो मॉनिटरिंग। नाउ वी कैन सी दिस ट्यूमर विच इज वस्कुलर सॉफ्ट एंड सकेबल विथ गुड प्लेन्स। See here, called and there is a tumor. There is a very very good plane present. So itself it gives some idea because the ependymoma has provide always very good plane for dissection. Now this is the neuromonitoring slide. SSEP MEP was monitored before and the after the procedure, both are entire pre and post. There was no deficit on the records. This is the post immediate post op. Patient was in recovery. Now post operative there was no motor weakness. He is able to lift his both leg. This is right leg, this is left leg. He is able to lift both legs, so there was no post op motor weakness. Histopath report was suggestive of papillary ependymoma WHO grade 2. This is a post op MRI. This MRI was done after 3 months of surgery. There's no residual tumor. There's a lateral view. T2 also same. There's no contrast enhancement of intramedullary tumors. There's no tumor. Axial is intact. This is a 7 month post op. Now patient walking comfortably. Now he can walk for 7 to 8 kilometers. Here I want to say that intramedullary tumor, in view of intramedullary tumor, ependymoma is the most common tumor in adult populations with 50 to 60% incidence, and the age group is around 38 years is the mean age for the tumor, and the most common features are mild to moderate back pain, depend on the location. Cervical is the most common location, then lumbar, then dorsal, then lumbar. Pain is the first symptom before the myelopathy feature. Intraoperative neuromonitoring, SSEP and APP only, it is a main feature, main component we observe during the dissection. It has highly sensitivity and specificity. It provides anatomical landmark for the midline myelotomy, resection planes, and the guideline for extension of the maximum tumor resection with minimum neurological morbidity. But cost, assess availability of the technique, resources, and person for the intraoperative monitoring present as the challenge for the some medical centers. Intraoperative factors such as time, irrigation, and blood pressure optimize the facilitate recovery from the lost intraoperative signal remain promising as a main of mitigating neurological injury. Conclusion: mainstay of treatment of the intraoperative tumor remains surgical resection. With the help of intraoperative neuromonitoring, post-operative complication can be reduced with real-time monitoring. Thank you.
Dr. Ashutosh?
Yes, sir.
If there is a recurrence, what will you do?
Sorry, sir?
If there is a recurrence.
Yes, sir.
What will you do?
See, in same patient.
Pardon?
You are asking about the recurrence?
Yes.
But again, tumor is excision, sir. Because the recurrence is around 50%, 50-60%, the recurrence, possibility of recurrence is possible, and the it is a benign tumor, so we can operate. But re-operation lead, chances of deficit is more in re-operation. Again, we will monitor the entire process with the neuromonitoring to prevent, because my patient was 46, is very young, is a working person. If we can't compromise his leg powers and all things.
Is there any role of adjuvant therapy?
Adjuvant therapy, if I'm adjuvant therapy means there's no role of radiation therapy because it worsens the condition, but chemotherapy, lot of research going on, but not a single study which is giving satisfactory result, because some studies show 20% reduction of mass, some show 25% reduction of mass. But there are a lot of other options like surgical chemo and radiation, but surgical resection with neuromonitoring is the best modality of treatment, because with the help of this surgery and the monitoring, we are seeing live entire surgery is going through a systematic fashion with a live monitoring of the all the power and sensory components.
And what you did for the syringe?
Nothing, sir.
Okay.
Can I ask one question?
Yes, sir.
You are doing, you have exposed the taken out the laminae, exposed the dura, now the cord is visible.
Yes, sir.
And yeah, because of the intramedullary lesion of the tumor,
yes, sir.
The midline is likely to be distorted. How to identify the midline? I think you have done a midline myelotomy.
Yes, sir.
So how to identify the midline when there is a possibility that it is displaced by the tumor itself?
There was a white band like a structure there with the help of neuromonitoring probe.
Midline you identify with the neuromonitoring probe.
And basically the dorsal column, exactly, sir.
No, that's the very relevant point.
I don't want to bluff, sir. Sorry, sir.
Very good. You take the help of the artery in the midline dorsally. There's a tortuous vessel. You have shown nicely.
Sir.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ashutosh.